Jesus did God's work wherever he went. And his work always brought him close to people. Often, this happened in people's homes. Maybe you remember one of the stories we enjoyed recently. Jesus asked a tax collector named Levi, who was also called Matthew, to come along with him to do his work. The thing is, nobody wanted to eat with tax collectors. They were thought of as bad people who took too much money and only thought of themselves. But Jesus knew that Levi was one of God's children too, just like everybody else. So when Levi asked him to come to his house for a party and made Jesus the guest of honor, he was happy to go and eat with Levi and his tax collector friends. Another day, Jesus went to someone else's home. In that time, homes had a flat rooftop and often had stairs that would lead up to the roof on the outside of the house. We don't have stairs here with us today, but maybe you can imagine a set of stairs leading up to our roof. By that time, people had heard about Jesus. People had told each other stories about the amazing things Jesus said and did. The word was out that God had given Jesus the power to heal people of their sicknesses. Crowds of people followed Jesus around, waiting to hear what Jesus had to say and wanting him to heal them. Sometimes, Jesus would have to slip away from the crowds to be alone, so that he could talk with God. But in today's story, Jesus chose to be with the people. And boy, did people gather. People came from everywhere, all sorts of people. There were even religious experts there, ready to see who this Jesus was and what he had to say. So many people came that they filled the house up until there was no more room for even one more person. People even stood outside the door and tried to listen, hoping they could see Jesus when he came. On that day, there was a certain man who very much wanted to see Jesus. Maybe more than anyone else. He was paralyzed, which meant that he couldn't move his legs. He could never walk, no matter how much he tried. He had to live his life always sitting or laying down. But in at least one way, this man was very fortunate. You see, he had a group of friends, and these friends, they loved him so much. So much that they wanted to take him to Jesus, hoping that Jesus would heal him. So they carried him on his mat to the house where Jesus was. There were so many people there that it was too crowded to get in. It looked like they would not be able to see Jesus after all. But those friends, no, they would not give up. Their friend needed to be healed, and they believed Jesus could do it. So they made a plan. They carried their paralyzed friend up those stairs to the roof. They removed some of the slats and with some rope, they carefully lowered their friend down to Jesus. Jesus saw how much this man and his friends believed. He said to the paralyzed man, "I tell you, stand up, get your mat, and go home." So the man stood up, he took his mat, and he went home, thanking and praising God. Everybody was amazed and left praising God and saying, "We've never seen anything like that before." I wonder, what's your favorite part of this story? I wonder how the paralyzed man felt when his friends said they would take him to see Jesus. I wonder what Jesus thought when he saw someone make a hole in the roof and then lower a man down through it. I wonder how the man felt after he was healed. I wonder how his friends felt. I wonder how others felt after seeing the man be healed. I wonder what message about friendship God may be telling us in this story. I wonder how God wants us to help out our friends. I wonder what message about Jesus God may be telling us in this story.